Jayanthi, Thalapathi from Gateway, the complete school. So today's topic is lattice energy. So today we are going to see how to calculate the lattice energy when two gaseous ions react together to get an ionic solid. So over here, actually the basic concept was Hess law. So in Hess law, elements, so whatever elements going to react, that element, from those elements you need to get the ions. So you will get the gaseous ions, from gaseous ions only you will get the ionic solid. So over here, elements to ionic solid is a direct way, and when you get ions and through ions, then if you get ionic solid, then it is an indirect way. So direct way is the enthalpy change of formation, and the indirect way is equal to ionization plus lattice energy, enthalpy change of lattice energy. So from this basic, again the enthalpy cycle, if you say enthalpy cycle, this is this follows Hess's law. So over here the elements are, I have taken lithium fluoride as an example. So over here the elements are lithium and fluorine. So from here the element lithium, I have shown the state over here. So over here it's solid. So lithium from solid state to gaseous ion, gas, we are converting solid state to gaseous state. So here the enthalpy change of atomization is plus 161 kilojoules per mole. So it's positive. So that positive value shows the process is endothermic. Once you get the gaseous atom, then the atom, you have to convert the atom into ion. So over here, ionization. When an element loses its electron, that shows ionization. So I1, that means first ionization. So when lithium loses its electron, it ionizes. So over here, this is also an endothermic reaction. That's the reason it has a positive value. Then again, once you get lithium ion, next you need to concentrate on the anion. So over here, fluorine. So half F2, that shows gaseous molecule. So from molecule to atom. So molecule to atom, converting something, a molecule to atom, is also atomization. So over here, atomization of fluorine. Atomization of fluorine also has a positive value, that shows this is also endothermic reaction. So over here, once you get a fluorine gaseous atom, so gaseous atom to ion. So when this ionizes, here you can't say ionization, this is called electron affinity. That means when it gains an electron, when fluorine gains an electron, it becomes F minus. Actually, this is an exothermic reaction, because this needs some energy, this will release some energy when you get ion. So over here, once you get ion, so gaseous ions, once you get gaseous ions, this will give the ionic solid. So when you get the ionic solid from the gaseous ions, it will release some energy. That energy is called lattice energy. So over here, clearly given, to calculate lattice energy, you need the formation, from the formation you need to subtract the ionization, H1. So when you subtract this, so what is H1 over here? It's enthalpy change of atomization of lithium, and enthalpy change of ionization of lithium, and atomization of fluorine, and electron affinity of fluorine. So you have to subtract this to get the lattice energy, because that clearly shows the direct way is delta HF, that means the enthalpy change of formation, and you have to subtract delta H1, that means ionization, to get the lattice energy. So here, this concept is very clearly given in Born-Haber cycle. So in Born-Haber cycle, they have clearly shown which is endothermic and which is exothermic. So over here, this is enthalpy change of formation. So by the elements, from the elements you can get the product over here. So this is enthalpy change of formation. Enthalpy change of formation, again I'm telling you, this is also an exothermic, that's why negative minus 617 kilojoules per mole. And over here, again the
same concept where what you have applied over there, same concept, lithium solid state to gas. So solid to gas, gas again it's a atomization. So atomization of lithium and ionization of lithium, and once you get the ion, lithium ion, then you need to concentrate on fluorine. So over here it's a gaseous molecule, gaseous molecule to atom, then atom to ion. So over here these arrows shows upwards, right? So when the arrow shows upwards, those shows it's endothermic, which gets energy, which takes in energy for the reaction. So over here, once you get fluorine to fluorine ion, it is exothermic reaction. That means this releases energy. So that's why negative value, minus 328 kilojoules per mole. So once you get both the ions, and again from the gaseous ions to get the product, as we have seen over here, it is the enthalpy change of lattice energy is again, it's a negative, that shows it is also an exothermic reaction. So this is what we have seen in lithium fluoride. This as an example in lithium fluoride, this is what the enthalpy change. Yeah, so this is how we need to calculate the lattice energy when you get the ionic solid from the ions. Thank you so much for watching this video. Goodbye.